I'm Micah Smith, and in today's quick tip, we're going to look at embedding JavaScript within your bot. So let's take a look at this example I've got here. I've got a set start time, a do some stuff, and a set end time step in my bot. Now, if we look at what's actually inside here, it's really pretty simple. I've got two commands. I've got a date time assign, which is taking the current system date and setting that to a date time variable of start time. It's then going to convert that date time start variable to a string in the month, month, day, day, year, year, hour, hour, minute, minute, second, second format. Okay. So at that point, I'll just have a string that has my current date and time. From then, we're going into the do some stuff block, which is really just set to simulate what a normal bot run would be. So maybe that's running for 5 minutes, running for 3 hours, whatever it might be. Here, we're just going to have a random delay between 3 and 12 seconds. And then I've got my end time block, which is the same as my start time, where I'm taking the current date time, I'm converting that to a string, in this case, S end time as my string. Okay, so that's a background of what we've got right now. This lab or this section, we're going to look at how to actually use the JavaScript command. So in my command palette here, I've got the JavaScript package, and I want to specifically look at the open action first. So I'm going to drag that over. Now, when I'm using JavaScript within my bot, I have the ability to point to a JavaScript file. It would be like just a .js extension in the control room that could be on my desktop, or I could actually manually put that in line in my bot. And that's what I'm gonna do for this lab. So let me grab a function that I put together real quick. And this is just gonna help us to calculate the date time difference, or the time difference, I guess I should say, between two dates. So what it's doing is it's taking in a list here that we've called dates. It's going to then take the first date as date 0 and the second date as date 1. And then it's going to find out the difference between those two dates. And it's going to calculate that in the format of seconds, minutes, and hours as a return. Okay. So when we actually want to execute our JavaScript, we need to add the run JavaScript action. Let's go back here one time. Let me just copy this. So we'll have to have the name of our function. Let me just copy that out. When we call the run JavaScript. So here, I'll put the name of my function. I also need to pass in parameters, and with the JavaScript action, it actually takes in a list. So I have a list of dates. Now, right now, my list of dates is totally empty. So let's go back and fill that out. Right now, I've got my start time captured. What I'm going to do is go to the list package right here. I'm going to select add item. So I've got a list variable, which is ldates. Right now, it has nothing in it. I just created that a minute ago. And I can add an item to it. In this case, I want to add the string for start time. And I'll add that to the end of the list and hit save. And that will be the first value in my list. I'll do the same thing with end time. So I'm going to add item to the list variable of ldates. And the item to add is my string of sendTime. And that will be added to the end of the list. So that'll put it in position index 1, but position 2. I'll hit save. Minimize that again. Okay, so I'm passing in a list of the two date times, and then I can assign that output or the return to a variable. And I'm going to select the prompt assignment here and hit save. And then the last thing we'll do is grab a message box to, let's say, total processing time, and then we'll enter the prompt assignment. Hit save and then run. So I don't necessarily have to pass in multiple values. In this case, I wanted to because of the type of calculation we're doing with the JavaScript. But if you're just running any other kind of JavaScript, you don't necessarily have to pass in multiple values if you don't want to. So what this is gonna do, calculate that difference between our start time and our end time and post it here. So this is in the format of hours, minutes, and seconds. The bot processing time was 10 seconds, and we calculated that by using inline JavaScript. Thanks for checking out today's quick tip. Like, subscribe, and comment on our social channels for more quick tips. Thanks for your time. Go be great.